Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video we are going to study multi-row or group functions, or you can say aggregate functions also. So in previous video we have studied about single row function, and in this video we will learn about multi-row functions. Question is, what is multi-row function? In multi-row functions, the functions are operated upon multiple values, and those multiple values are obtained from multiple rows of a particular column. That means all values of a particular column will be obtained to function for the functioning of multi-row functions. And that column should be numeric. Generally, these functions works on numeric column, except count. Count works on all types of columns. Min and max also works on various types of columns. But sum and AVG will work on numeric columns. So these are also called as aggregate functions because it summarizes the result of a query and returns a single value calculated from multiple values present in a column. बहुत सारी values को summarize कर देता है, उसका aggregation करके एक value return करता है. जैसे average निकालना हो आपको, तो आपको 10 value चाहिए. आपको sum निकालना हो तो एक value का sum निकाल के क्या करोगे? You have to have so many values. So those so many values are obtained from so many rows of one column. It is called group function because it works on group of values. There are five types of group functions that we have to study, and that is part of our curriculum. Number one, sum, AVG, that is average, max, maximum, min, minimum, and count. Let us study these functions one by one. Here, sum function, it returns the arithmetic total of all the values present in a particular numeric columns only. Consider the following, yani ki jo numeric column hoga uski values ka, uski sabhi values ka sum kiya ja sakta hai. Either all values or selected values. Selected values kaise karenge aap? Where clause laga denge. To agar where clause nahi laga rahe, filter condition nahi laga rahe, that means all values will be summed up, will be added, and you will have the final answer, what is the sum. Consider this table EMP. In this we have a salary column named sal. Iski sabhi salaries ko aapko maan lijiye total karna hai, to aap likhenge kya command? Select sum within bracket sal from EMP. It is very simple. Select sum of sal, इसे रीड करेंगे, सेलेक्ट सम ऑफ सेल फ्रॉम ईएमपी, सो यू विल गेट वन आंसर, दैट इज यू कैन सी हियर 298,000 इज कमिंग आउट. सो दैट इज द टोटल ऑफ ऑल द सैलरीज ऑफ दिस कॉलम. रिमेंबर दैट दीज फंक्शंस जनरली वर्क्स ऑन नॉन नल वैल्यूज. नल वैल्यूज आर जनरली इग्नोर्ड. अगर आप यहाँ हुएर लगा देते हैं, सम, select sum of cell from EMP, where some, you put some condition where department number equal to 10, then you will have the total of the salaries of all the employees of department number 10. It means out of these values of cell column, only few values will be added, and that will depend upon the criteria or condition that you are specifying. So yahan aap where bhi laga sakte hain finally. Next function is AVG. The table is same. Suppose I want to find out the average salary. तो इस salary column की जो values हैं उसका average निकालने के लिए the process is same. Select AVG of cell from EMP. So AVG of cell, average of salary will be calculated 42,571. अच्छा, एक यहाँ पर आपको बता देना चाहता हूँ. अगर मान लीजिए अभी ये कितनी रो है, देर आर 7 रोज, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. सो ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ सेल कॉलम हैज बीन एडेड एंड डिवाइडेड बाय 7. सपोज दैट देर आर टू नल वैल्यूज इन बिटवीन दीज वैल्यूज ऑफ सेल कॉलम, अगर दो नल वैल्यूज हैं तो क्या होगा? सो ऑल द टोटल ऑफ ऑल द वैल्यूज ऑफ दिस सैलरी कॉलम डिवाइडेड बाय 5 हो जाएगा, नॉट 7. मींस ऑलवेज वो 7 से डिवाइड नहीं करेगा. इट विल डिपेंड कि इफ ऑल वैल्यूज विद इन दैट कॉलम आर नल नॉट नल, दैट मींस समथिंग. सो सम ऑफ दीज वैल्यूज विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय नंबर ऑफ रूट्स और नंबर ऑफ वैल्यूज. इफ सम वैल्यूज आर नल इन दिस कॉलम, देन द सम ऑफ द सैलरीज विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय नंबर ऑफ रूज विच आर हैविंग नॉन नल वैल्यूज. नल विल बी इग्नोर्ड, रिमेंबर. क्लियर? अगर यहां पर दो कॉलम दो वैल्यूज नल होंगी तो इसका जो सम है वो 5 से डिवाइड होगा. अगर सारी वैल्यूज न्यूमेरिक हैं, नल नहीं है, तो यहां 7 रो है, 7 से डिवाइड होगा. 7 वैल्यूज आर देयर, सो इट विल बी डिवाइडेड बाय 7. सो दिस इज हाउ एवरेज इज कैलकुलेटेड. रिमेंबर इट, इट इज पॉइंट टू रिमेंबर. Now max function also finds out maximum value out of number of values, but null values will also be ignored here. So here out of these salaries, which is the highest salary, that is 86,250, you can observe that 86,250 is highest value. As I told you that it works on numeric column as well as other data type also. See here on date, if I apply max function, so select max of join date from EMP. So maximum date is 15th May 2010. Here you can see 15th May 2010. 18-12-1990. 15 May 2010. 1990 is lower. 2010 is higher. So this is the highest date. Thereafter, select max of ename from EMP, highest name. Highest name means A to Z, towards Z. So that is Smith. Smith is the highest name. First of all, we are getting Smith. Therefore, it is the highest. यहाँ पर एक और है, Seth भी है, but Smith and Seth will be compared. S is cancelled. M बाद में आता है, E पहले आता है, इसलिए Smith is the highest name. So this is max name. Similarly, it is quite similar to min function, but it calculates the lowest value. So lowest value out of it is 28,750. Select min of cell from EMP ka result aa gaya aapka 28,750. Min of ename is Abdul because it starts from A. It calculates according to ASCII code. So ASCII code of A is least in comparison of A to Z any letter, and that is why Abdul is coming out. Select min of join date from EMP. Minimum date is being displayed, that is 18-12-1990. This is the least date. So this is min function. Now we come to count function. It returns counting of number of non-null values present in the particular column only. किसी कॉलम में आप नॉन नल वैल्यूज को काउंट करता है काउंट फंक्शन. काउंट और को दो तरह से यूज कर सकते हैं, एक तो काउंट विद इन ब्रैकेट कॉलम नेम, दूसरा काउंट स्टार. इफ यू राइट काउंट स्टार, इट विल काउंट नंबर ऑफ रोज विद इन द टेबल, नंबर ऑफ रोज विद इन द टेबल. सपोज इन सर्टेन केस द कंप्लीट रो इज नल, ऑल वैल्यूज आर नल. सपोज ये 1103 सेट सेल्समैन 34,000 और ये डेट और ये डिपार्टमेंट नंबर, एवरीथिंग इज नल इन अ पार्टिकुलर रो, सो दैट रो विल बी इग्नोर्ड, अदरवाइज ऑल विल बी काउंटेड. इफ देयर इज एनी वन वैल्यू विद इन दिस रो एज नॉन नल, सो दैट रो विल बी काउंटेड, इट विल बी टेकन इन द काउंटिंग. सो काउंट स्टार काउंट्स ऑल रोज ऑफ द टेबल, सो इट विल रिटर्न 7. Let us see through example. Select count join date from EMP. In join date, you can say non-null values are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that is why it is returning 5. Count join date is 5. null values are not counted in a particular column. Select count cell from EMP. Whereas in cell column, you can see there are all 7 values. There is no any null value, therefore it is returning 7. Then count, select count star from EMP. Star, as I told you, that it counts number of rows within the table. So there are 7 rows, 7 is being displayed. There is no any row in this table having null values, and this is a rare condition. Koi row aisi hogi hi nahi jisme na sari null values ho. Isliye us row ko wo count karega hi karega using count star. Ek aur tarika hai, select count distinct job from EMP. So sabse pehle ise solve kar lijiye. Select distinct job means it will count types of jobs. तो एक क्लर्क है, एक एग्जीक्यूटिव, एक मैनेजर, एक सेल्समैन. सो देयर आर 4 टाइप्स ऑफ जॉब. सो इट विल काउंट डिस्टिंक्ट जॉब. सो काउंट करेगा कितना? 4, राइट? देयर आर 4 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ जॉब्स, यूनिक टाइप्स ऑफ जॉब्स, दैट विल बी काउंटेड. सो सच क्वेरीज कैन बी रन यूजिंग काउंट फंक्शन. काउंट फंक्शन में आप किसी पार्टिकुलर कॉलम पर लगा सकते हैं, या काउंट स्टार लगा सकते हैं, या काउंट डिस्टिंक्ट के साथ लगा सकते हैं. दीज आर द 3 फॉर्मेट्स हाउ काउंट कैन बी यूज्ड. नेक्स्ट, ग्रुप बाय क्लॉज. द ग्रुप बाय स्टेटमेंट और क्लॉज ग्रुप्स रोज दैट हैव द सेम वैल्यूज इनटू समरी रोज. लाइक फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ कस्टमर्स इन ईच कंट्री, find the number of student in each section, find the number of books of each category type. So like that, if you want to categorize some data into various categories and then apply aggregate functions sum, max, min, avg and count, for that purpose group by statement is used, right? So group by, whenever you will be using group by function, that means you are going to use these functions also. Group by clause ka jab bhi istemal karoge, to aap count, max, min, sum, avg, in mein se koi na koi aap function us statement mein use karne ja rahe ho. That is why you are going to implement or apply group by clause within select statement, right? So let us see through example, it will be clear. Suppose I have a table. In the left side, you can see the table name AABCC. The name is being repeated. इसके लिए ये criteria होनी चाहिए कि एक column जिसकी value repeat हो रही है, उसी पर हम group by लगाते हैं. तो ध्यान दीजिए, यहाँ पर name एक ऐसा column है जिसमें हमारी values AA is coming 2 times, B is once and C is coming 2 times. That is why the values of this column are being repeated, so that we can apply group by on name. And aggregate functions आप values पर लगा सकते हैं, because it is a numeric column. So let us see how it is applied. मैं चाहता हूँ कि हर name का जो values हैं वो sum होकर के आएँ. This summary I want. तो AA को अगर मैं ग्रुप बनाऊंगा, A पर ग्रुप बनेगा तो उसका समेशन ऑफ वैल्यू 30 हो जाएगा. B पर ग्रुप बनेगा तो उसका समेशन ऑफ वैल्यू 40 रहेगा, क्योंकि देर इज ओनली वन वैल्यू इन B. C पर अगर ग्रुप बनेगा तो इट विल बी गिविंग आउट 70. सी, यू कैन सी हेयर. सो हाउ कमांड कैन बी गिवेन? सेलेक्ट नेम. नेम हैज टू बी डिस्प्लेड. नेम को आप लोग अगर ना कहा जाए तब भी डिस्प्ले कर लें, क्योंकि सेलेक्ट में लिख लें, क्योंकि जिस पर ग्रुप बनाएं उसको पहला कॉलम डिस्प्ले करें. सपोज देर इज नो नेम कॉलम इज नॉट प्रेजेंट इन द रिजल्ट, देन हाउ यू विल आइडेंटिफाई कि 30 किसका सम है, 40 किसका सम है एंड 70 किसका सम है. दैट इज व्हाई द कॉलम ऑन विच ग्रुप इज बीइंग मेड, तो दैट कॉलम मस्ट बी सेलेक्टेड इन द सेलेक्ट स्टेटमेंट, राइट? तो उसे आप अनवांटेडली ही सेलेक्ट कर लें, चाहे पूछा जाए आपसे चाहे ना पूछा जाए. बिकॉज फॉर ईच नेम यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द सम. फॉर ईच नेम इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द एवरेज, इफ यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट द मैक्स, मीन, काउंटिंग, सो इन दैट केस यू विल यूज ग्रुप बाय. सेलेक्ट नेम कॉमा सम ऑफ वैल्यू. सम ऑफ वैल्यू इसी तरह से मैक्स ऑफ वैल्यू, मीन ऑफ वैल्यू, एवीजी ऑफ वैल्यू, काउंट ऑफ वैल्यू या काउंट ऑफ स्टार कैन बी रिटन फ्रॉम सैंपल अंडरस्कोर टेबल, दिस इज नेम ऑफ द टेबल, ग्रुप बाय नेम। लास्ट में फ्रॉम लिखने के बाद वेयर भी लगाना चाहो तो लगा दो, एंड एट द एंड यू विल राइट ग्रुप बाय दैट पर्टिकुलर कॉलम इन विच सम वैल्यूज आर बीइंग रिपीटेड ऑन विच यू वांट टू ग्रुप। सो यू विल सी द रिजल्ट फॉर ईच नेम, सम ऑफ द वैल्यूज हैज बीन डन फॉर ईच नेम वैल्यू, सम ऑफ द वैल्यू हैज बीन डन, राइट? सो ए 30, बी 40, सी 70, एज आई टोल्ड यू। Now let us do it practically. See, select count star sum of cell AVG of cell from EMP. अगर आप करते हैं तो you will have one row answer. Count star counting all rows, sum of salary adding sum of salaries values of all the rows, AVG of cell finding out the average of all the salaries. Okay, here I am not using group by. I am just want to tell you the difference. Ki if I use aggregate functions without group by, then what is the result? And if we use aggregate functions with group by, then what is the result? तो यहाँ आप देखें एक ही row में result आ रहा है अगर मैं aggregate functions बहुत सारे इस्तेमाल कर रहा हूँ on a table. As soon as we use group by, then what happens? This same thing has been bifurcated in number of groups. तो ये चीज कई groups में, कई rows में distribute हो जाता है as soon as we apply group by. अब group by किस पर लगा सकते हो? We can implement group by on the column in which some values are being repeated. See, यहाँ पर देखिए आप, I am applying group by on job. In job column you can see clerk. क्लर्क, सो इन दोनों की सैलरीज अगर हम वहां सम फंक्शन यूज करेंगे तो इन दोनों की सैलरीज ऐड होकर के आएंगी. सेल्समैन इट विल बी एडेड, 34,500 एंड 34,500 विल बी एडेड. मैनेजर इज ओनली वन, नथिंग टू ऐड. एग्जीक्यूटिव आर टू, 29,000 एंड 40,000 विल बी एडेड इफ आई एम यूजिंग सम फंक्शन. सिमिलरली फॉर एवरेज एंड अदर फंक्शंस आल्सो. सो you can make the group on department number also, because the values in the department number are being repeated. Department number 10 10 10, suppose you want to find out some of the salaries department for each department, so you can implement group by on department number, right? So you might have understood. Otherwise wherever on which column the values are being repeated, so there only you can apply group by. You will apply group by on one column and calculation of implementation of aggregate functions on some other column having numeric values or whatever, as I told you earlier what is the quality of these aggregate functions. So here if I write select count star sum of cell AVG of cell from EMP group by job, then the same result that was coming in one row is bifurcated in four rows. Why in four rows? Because there are four categories of job. But it is very difficult in this query to identify ki first row aapki kis job ki hai, second row kaun se job ki hai, third row kaun se job ki hai, and so on. So for that purpose, as I told you earlier, you have to select that particular column also on which the group is being made. So here group is being made on job column, that is why job should be the first column selected. Therefore you can it will be quite clear to the users ki which group is for which column. So here the same thing is implemented. Select yahan par job has been selected here as a first column because we are creating group by on job. So select job comma count star sum of cell AVG of cell from EMP group by job. So the same result is coming out, but the first column is clerk, executive, manager, salesman. These job types are coming, each job type is coming only once in the result because this is the group of clerk. Clerk, there are two clerks, their sum of salary is this much, average of salary is this much. Executive. There are two executives. Their sum of salary is this. Aggregate, I mean, this average salary is this. Manager is only one. This is the salary of the manager and this is average also. Ek value ka average wahi aayega. Salesman, there are two salesmen having total salary this and average salary this. So in this way you can see how group by has been implemented. So very important to remember is the column on which you are making the group, that must be in the select list. Next, see, select count star, sum of salary, average of salary from MP, group by department number. You can make the group on department number also. So same, in the same way you are having the result, but department number is not selected. That is why it is difficult to identify the group of each department. So let us select the department number also. Select department number, count star, sum of sale, AVG of sale, max of sale from EMP, group by department number. So the column on which you are making the group must be given in the select list. So this is the group of department number 10, this is the group of 20, this is the group of 30. That means in department number 10 there are 3 employees, in 20 there are 2 employees, in 30 there are 2 employees. So their sum of salary, average of salary and maximum of salary is being displayed. Now you can put where condition also. So where, as I told you that from, after from clause, you will put the where clause. And at last you will apply group by. So accordingly I am writing this command, select department number on which the grouping is to be made. Count star, one function, sum of cell, AVG of cell, max of cell from EMP, where department number greater than 10. That means this time I want the grouping for those departments having department number greater than 10. That means 20, 30 ki hi grouping chahiye. Group by department number. So first of all you have filtered all the rows having department number greater than 10. So all rows that is having department number 20 and 30 have been filtered, and on those rows we are applying group by. So we are having only two group here, you can see. We are not having group on column, I mean department number 10, because that is filtered where department number greater than 10. So this is the two group formed on department number 20 and department number 30. Group by you can implement on two columns also, three columns also, provided within first column second column is also repeating, then only it will be shown to you. Otherwise it will be difficult to identify. First column should be repeated, and within first column second column values should also be repeated, then only it can be identified. Now select job comma department number. On these two columns we are going to form the group. Then count star, aggregate function, sum cell, AVG cell, max cell from EMP, group by job comma department number. That means first grouping will be done on job, then second grouping will be done on department number. See, clerk, first grouping on job, that is clerk. There are two clerks, and fortunately both the clerks are of department number 20. That is why it is giving one thing. Otherwise it could have given 10 20, department number 10 in for clerk, department number 10 for clerk, department number 20 it could have given. So here clerk, there are two clerks having department number 20 only, so their data is coming out. Executive is one, department number 10 mein hai. There are two executives, so their data is coming out. Manager, there is only one manager of department number 10, data is here. Salesman, department number 30, data is coming out. So you can do grouping on two departments also, I mean two columns also, multiple columns also. Now there is another clause, having clause. So out of groups, if you want to have filter conditions, jitane group ban rahe hain unme se bhi aapko filter condition lagani hai ki out of those groups only few groups should be displayed, rest of the groups should be suppressed. To iske do tarike hain, ya to aap pehle where laga do aur fir having ki zarurat nahi padegi, या तो आप जो है वेयर नहीं लगाते हो तो हैविंग आपको जरूरत पड़ेगी. रिमेंबर दैट हैविंग इज यूज्ड ओनली विद ग्रुप बाय क्लॉज. इफ यू आर नॉट यूजिंग ग्रुप बाय क्लॉज इन अ क्वेरी देन हैविंग नीड नॉट टू बी यूज्ड. देन वेयर इज सफिशियंट. ओके, रिमेंबर दैट हैविंग क्लॉज विल बी यूज्ड ओनली व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग ग्रुप बाय क्लॉज. रिमेंबर, अदरवाइज इन द क्वेरी यू कैन यूज where clause as it is to filter out the rows from the table. Now select job. On job you are making group. Count star, aggregate functions hain, sum cell, avg cell, max cell, from emp, group by job. Up to this point it is okay. You have made the group on the job and displayed some aggregate functions values. Now having job in clerk comma salesman, what does it mean? Having job equal to clerk or job equal to salesman. As I told you that or operator or logical operator can be replaced with in operator. The same here I am doing here. Or you can write job equal to clerk or job equal to salesman. That condition is also okay. So condition formation you should know, that is the part of previous curriculum. So here it has made the group on clerk, salesman, executive and manager. But out of those groups, you are putting the condition ki out of those groups on job, only we should display the groups of clerk and salesman which satisfy this condition. So here in the query result, you can see clerk and salesman group is being displayed. The rest of the groups has been made but suppressed, not being displayed on the screen. Next example of having clause is select job, count star, sum cell, avg cell, max cell, from emp, group by job. Having count star greater than equal to 2, having ke sath aap ye condition jo hai aggregate functions par bhi dal sakte hain. Having sum of cell greater than this, equal to this, less than this. Having count star greater than equal to 2 is showing that those groups will be displayed in which number of employees are greater than or equal to 2. So here you can see if number of employees are greater than or equal to 2, only those groups are being displayed in the query output, otherwise being suppressed, not displayed. Similarly, here also select job, count star, sum cell, avg cell, max cell, from emp, group by job. Having some cell greater than equal to 70,000. So only those groups will be displayed which will satisfy this criteria. Sum of cell whose total salary is greater than equal to 70,000. Only those groups are being displayed in the query output. So this is group by and having clause, right? So today you have studied in this video aggregate functions, that is sum, max, min, avg, count, sum, max, min, avg, count, and which one? Sum, max, min, avg, count, five functions, and thereafter group by clause and having clause. So I think you might have understood. If you have not understood, please pause the video in between and try to understand and do it practically on your system. Then only it will be very much clear to all of you. And if you have liked this video, please like, share and subscribe, and share with your friends also. So thank you very much. Thank you.